So the halo matrix system, it is a system that is comprised of three main components: the rings, the matrix by itself, and the wedges. The rings are meant to create two things: to create a separation force, to keep the matrix in position. Those two things are fundamental from a ring. The matrix is there to give us guidance and to give us back the anatomy and everything that this means to the restoration, a good contact point, a good adaptation and everything. And the wedge is there also, ideally to provide some separation, but mainly to adapt the matrix into the cervical region, making sure that we don't have any excesses, that we don't have any flashes. Starting with the rings, what the rings bring new to the table, that it is, let's say, superior to what we already have. The first thing, in my opinion, it is that the fact that they're narrow. They're narrow, and that means that they are easy to place anywhere in the oral cavity, especially when we're talking about first upper molars, second upper molars. Some of the rings that we have available in the market, they're hard to place. Sometimes it is impossible to place. The plastic portion that does the separation, that holds the matrix in place and also creates the force of separation, again, that compensates for the thickness of the matrix, it has some beaks designed. And this beak helps in adapting the matrix even better. And what that means, clinically speaking, it means that there's less flesh. I don't need to remove so much flesh from buccal and lingual. So it helps us a lot in adapting better the matrix on buccal to lingual aspect of the tooth. So in addition to what I've spoken about the rings, there's one final thing I would like to talk about. It is the plastic portion, how it feels stronger, how it feels more long-lasting, and how it feels more hygienic also. Easier to clean, easier to process, easier. It looks cleaner and it looks stronger. The new halo wedges, they are firmer. They are not as flexible as the plastic wedges that we've been using. We all know that the basic thing that a wedge does on a Class II restoration, it is to provide a good adaptation of the matrix band into the tooth, so we don't have flashes, we don't have excesses. And halo wedges, they do that, but much more. They bring back the feeling that we had with the wooden wedges, which is also an active separation. So what they do, they will adapt the matrix into the tooth. They do that in a way that doesn't harm the papilla, but they bring back the active wedging feel that we don't have with the plastic wedges that are available. We had from the old wooden wedges. So it's marrying, it is getting back the best of both worlds. The bands are awesome because it is hard to spot what we can see. It is very subtle, but it makes a huge clinical difference. I guess the first one for me, it is the fact that there is a little anatomy that has been created that helps us on the marginal ridge. Everybody knows, and almost every dentist does a lot of Class II restorations. And the first place that we need, usually, that we need to do the occlusal adjustment, it is on the marginal ridge. The halo matrices, it helps us in giving us more guidance where the marginal ridge should be. And this helps a lot in saving time with the occlusal adjustment. I guess that's the first one. Also, it's available in several sizes. So premolars, molars, for children, for adults, for larger adults and smaller adults. So it is easier to adapt. Another thing that it is fundamental, it is where and how big the contact point it is. More than a contact point, it helps us in creating a contact surface. The more surface, the better. And also where the contact point is. It helps us in bringing the contact point not too close to occlusal. It brings a little closer to the medium third to make sure that even after occlusal adjustment, we still have the contact point. And this makes the whole difference in terms of what? There's no food entrapment, that there is less risk of secondary caries and so on for the in terms of longevity. One last thing I'd like to talk about is thickness. So all of the bands, they have the same thickness, regardless of size and regardless also if it is the rigid or the original. So we have the original, that it is a little bit more soft. We have the firm, which is a little bit more rigid. Both of them, they have the same thickness. This comes because of the heat treatment that undergoes the material, that the metal, that the stainless steel goes. It is the same treatment that the samurai sword goes. One portion, the blade of the samurai sword, is very hard, is very rigid, so it cuts very well. But the sword as a whole also bends very much. What creates that is the heat treatment that the blade and the back of the sword goes. It is the same thing with halo matrix system. The metal, we have the same thickness. One, it can be more rigid depending on how it was the heat treatment. The other one can be softer depending on how it was the heat treatment. Still, same thickness. I think I like halo because we have good systems, good sectional matrices in the market. But halo raised the bar in the sense that it is getting my life easier without compromising on the things that we already achieved. So it is a ring that gives me a big and better adaptation. It is a ring that looks cleaner and it is stronger. It is a matrix that has a little bend, and only a dentist will know that the occlusal adjustment usually starts on the marginal ridge. So having a little guidance of the marginal ridge, saving me time, it is something that, you know, you feel understood, that someone understands our pain. And the wedge bringing back the good feeling of active wedging without compromising on adaptation, without compromising on being gentle on the papilla. That's what I like about the halo system. It is giving me an easier and better life and a better outcome without compromising with the things that the technology already gave us.